When I was 8 years old, my mother allowed me to go to a mixed birthday party of my neighbor Gregory. And although it was mixed, the girls were playing inside the house and the boys were playing outside. But after a while, I was bored playing with the girls. So I looked outside and suddenly my attention was taken by a group of boys who were peeing together against a tree. And I was fascinated. I was fascinated by the thing they had between their legs, which gave them the ability to pee standing up. And I went outside and I asked them what it was. A flute, someone said. That's impossible, I answered. It's true, another one said. And what do you have? And I told them that I had a Spanish singer between my legs. And they all laughed at me. And I said, okay, if you show me your flute, I will show you my Spanish singer. And immediately, all of them showed me their flute. I took off my pants, I threw my legs in the air, and suddenly, from between my legs, everybody could hear Viva España. The music twirled up like the smoke of a good Cuban cigar, and when I closed my legs, it sounded more like Gregorian chant music. So I could play with it. And in the meantime, the boys came closer, they took out their castanets, and they stimulated me to go on. And I thought, wow, if this continues, maybe someone will dance the flamenco. And yes, indeed, that someone came and approached me. It was a man. It was Gregory's father. He slapped me in the face and shouted, "You slut!" When I was 17 years old, my best friend Brenda and I, we went to a bar next to the station in Ghent. We went there because we both were in love with Rocco, the sexiest waiter in the bar. And every time we sat there, Brenda asked me the same question. "Do you think Rocco fancies me?" And every time I answered her, "Yes, I really do. He looks at you all the time." But inside I thought, "Over my dead body, you ugly turtle. He's mine. For you, it's just a game. For me, it's real love." But a bit later, everything changed. Because I went to the toilet. When I went to the toilet, Rocco suddenly forced my door and pushed me on my knees. "Putana, mi mostra il tits," he shouted and unzipped his pants. I was scared and flabbergasted, but I was also very impressed by his love pencil because it was big, but also flat like a sled. It was flat like a sled and it had a bend in the middle. It was a bit like a boomerang. A boomerang that came back in my face, again and again and again. And I had to avoid it. But after a while, I was tired and I couldn't avoid him anymore. Luckily, because the boomerang slapped my head, I hit the door opened, and I took the opportunity to escape. And I went back to my friend Brenda and I told her, "You know, Rocco fancies me. Come on, let's go." When I was 22 years old, I was invited by a friend to spend a holiday in Spain with her because she had moved there. And one evening, I was at a beach party, and at a certain moment, there was a man who had organized the beach party, and he offered me a place to stay, to sleep in his camper. And it was convenient because it was very late and my friend had already left the party with her boyfriend and I didn't know how to get back to her apartment. I trusted him, he was friendly. But I think he misunderstood me because although I told him very clearly that I didn't want to have sex with him, he raped me. But like I said, he was very friendly because while he was raping me below, And I was crying above. He comforted me by saying it wasn't all that bad. And he caressed my face with his big hand. After that evening, I told my Spanish singer that she was ugly, disgusting, and very, very bad. And I preferred her to stay in Spain while I went back to Belgium. At that moment, I think she lost her voice. When I was 29 years old, I was in therapy for eating disorders, and I wrote my diary every day. Every day I wrote, ouch, I, ow, help, help. Can somebody help me? Please, please? As a matter of fact, I helped myself. I mean, it helped to write things down. And I started to write theater. So when I was 37 years old, I had a man, a house, a beautiful son, and I was very successful in my job. Everything went great for a while. But when I was 49 years old, I had the feeling that my life was empty, my marriage was over, and I wanted a divorce. At that time, I had a lot of followers and listeners, but deep inside, I still felt speechless, angry, insecure. I think it was because I left something in Spain and I needed to call it back to be complete. And I did. But the journey was long. 3 years ago, I thought I found a solution to avoid pain and to keep my life in a balance. I decided to have no serious relationships anymore. I decided to go for the benefits and skip the troubles. I'm afraid I may have hurt a lot of people at that time because I was very severe and defensive. But then I met this man and he wanted a real relationship with me. Don't, I whispered in his ear, because I'll use you. It's okay, he said. You can use me if I can drive you. So now I'm 56 years old, and I'm deeply in love with myself. No, with my lover. 2 months ago, we were lying naked on the couch, and it felt so good. I felt at ease. I felt respected. And suddenly my lover asked me if I heard it too. He heard the whispering of a Spanish song, but the radio wasn't on. And suddenly I immediately looked between my legs, and yes, there she was, my Spanish singer. She came home and she had her voice back, silently but still. So right now, she takes some singing lessons, and maybe she will need the lessons for the rest of her life. But I have the feeling that with a little help from myself, my loved ones, and you, soon she will make music, like she did when she was 8 years old, and she sang E Viva España with the boys of the neighborhood. Thank you.